Welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. Today we have yet another Series X on the healing bench. This one has no display, it powers on perfectly fine. However, the port looks factory fresh. So, we're going to have to crack this open, see what the problem is. But first of all, let's connect him up to the TV and see what we get. HDMI 2, power's on, okay. Okay, fan's ramped up. There's a disc in the drive. So we should have had a display by now, and we're not getting one. NBA in the drive. Okay, it's official. Doesn't display. Wiggle test. Does feel a bit loose. Okay, that might be a bit too much movement. Not entirely sure, but there's absolutely nothing on the screen at all. And for a bit of perspective, that is what the standard port looks like. Looks pretty good. There's no real movement in it. Ooh, maybe there is. That may have come away from the board a little bit. Okay, let's get him apart. See what's going on. Okay, so a little bit of story time on this console. As you can see here, someone has definitely been in here before. This system has been to another repair shop and they have deemed it that the HDMI IC has popped in this. Their words, apparently, they have done tests. So, could be true. Could be the port. There is a little bit of movement in it, as you can see here, but I have some brand new IC, so we can test that. But first of all, let's look at that port. I mean, at least they haven't just bodged a hole right through. They've actually taken the time to cut this, which is borderline impressive. Okay, just a smattering of dust inside there. That's not too bad, I can work with that. I'm almost leaning towards that this hasn't been dug into. It hasn't even, these screws haven't been out. Although some of them activated the clutch on that, but all of them seem to be a uniform torqueness, if that's a word, torqued down to the same spec. And this power connector is quite tight. After at least one insertion and removal and insertion, these loosen up. If they did take it apart, they've done a good job of putting it back together. That's a fact. And here we are, under the scope. Here is the back of the HDMI port, and we can see all the pins along here. So we will just give them a nudge test. I don't expect any of them to be loose because these ports are very strong compared to PlayStation and others. I say that relatively. Okay, they feel good. There is some weird schmooage going on here. If someone has replaced that port, they've done a good job. It's just dust. And we have the HDMI IC here. All the TVS diodes are intact. Let's bust out the multimeter and see what's what. So if we put this in continuity, and hopefully you can hear that beep when I touch the leads. So when we make a circuit, we get a beep. And I'm just going to check these lines going to these TVS diodes, and then from them to the IC, just to make sure that these diodes aren't going short. And there's two pairs, there's four pairs. So we've got one, two, three, and four, and there are a diode for each side. So, okay, we get continuity there, and then there's a ground on this side. We shouldn't get a beep. And we don't. And if we follow that round to the, so this outside one, and follow that down, we go to this pin here. And we're good. We can check each one like that. No beep. No beep equals good. So we'll just quickly do that. Okay, so they're not shorted together. And just for speed, I'll just run straight past these and then go to the next one on the IC. Cool. And we'll move over to the next one. Cool. Good. Sorry, let me get the right angle here. Good. Next one. Good. 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 Next thing we need to do is go into diode mode. Let me see if I can get a shot of the multimeter. Okay, we can see the multimeter there. So we want positive on a ground. In fact, I actually have a clip that I can use. Move to positive. So I've got clip, I've got these stacked. So we'll clip him onto the chassis of the HDMI port. We'll check diode readings on these. So 0.661, that's good. We get nothing on pin 18. That's worrying. That's really worrying. That's ground. 0.6 is good. 0.6 is good. 0.6 is good. So we have the 5 volt line with no reading. Not good. Okay. Just checking on the HDMI IC here. Should all have similar-ish readings. Okay, so we have this one here. No. Ah, this one. Okay, that sounds like ground. So that buggers off into the board there. Don't have a short there. This. Okay, that looks normal. Okay, so we need to go and look at the other side of the board where the scary stuff is. And the scary stuff is a booster IC, which is a glass IC with BGA balls on the bottom of it. We also have a voltage regulator on there as well, which powers the circuit. So let's get this board out and see what we're dealing with there. Oh yeah, this has definitely been dug into. Look at the state of that. Oh, they've really messed that up. Oh, look at all this. That's just lazy. They've just like literally prized every single one. If you don't know, you don't know. Well, you just need to observe. Like I did, and figured out which ones you actually need to unclip. So it's these medium sized ones here with the large divot. One there, one there, one there, and one there. And then it's the same again. They alternate there, there, squint harder, there, and there. You just lift those ones and this pops straight off. You don't need to go, you know, special on it. Oh, and he's put tweezers in there to lift this off and dented it. I know this isn't overly important, but I mean, a bit of pride in your work. So if I, he's done that. Bent up to buggery. It's practically a horseshoe. I know you could literally just throw this in the bin and the Xbox would work perfect, but I mean, the whole point of this is probably just to tick a box for the like an EU regulation or something for EMI shielding filtering or something like that. So, but either way, oh, it's mullered that. Absolutely mullered. Anyway, onward and forward. How much thermal schmood do you think we're going to see? Lots? Enough? Too little? Answers on a postcard. The fourth option was the lazy option. Let's not clean off anything and just apply fresh on top of shit. And there's How have you got it all along here? Okay, so I'm going to have to inspect this board. I was praising him earlier for putting all the screws back. I'm currently retracting everything that I said positive. First things first, let's do a thorough visual inspection of the board. See if we can find any components knocked off, scrapes, shit stains, anything like that. Anything that's man-made. Any issues that are man-made. So let's go through the board and just give it a good observation. Because you never know, we might find something simple that way. So let's start at the important part. And here we have the scary circuit. He could have floated this BGA chip here, which is the HDMI booster IC. He could have floated that and it could have shifted. That does not look good. See the balls under that chip? So this is a glass IC. You have to be super careful with it. That is really high off the board. I can literally get my tweezer underneath that. You shouldn't be seeing that far underneath a BGA chip. Look at the state of that. That booster IC is hanging on by a thread. So that IC has been floated, which is in really close proximity to the HDMI port. So when you're hot airing that port off, it is super important that the board is rigid and isn't knocked or banged, because that is the result. So, oh my god, look at that. I've got to get a close up of this. Oh, that is so bad. I wish I could get more of a some more light on that. Look at that. That is a horror show. I mean, through the optics here that I'm seeing, that's quite a dark image that you guys are seeing. I'm seeing it in full Technicolor here. And yep, there's a ball. So on the right corner, there's a ball that's deformed and mangled. The next one to the left of it, that isn't even attached to the IC. It's attached to the PCB. But not the IC. Okay. I've seen that all that I need to see. Seen all that I need to see now. Man, that's bad. And just to put it into perspective on what we were looking at. That IC there, that grey square. Here is the HDMI port. And you heat up here. So that's in very close proximity. And when everything is molten round here and up to temperature, just a knock like that would shake that IC off the board slightly. I don't think I'm going to have to reball that. I'm going to go with a quick, cheeky reflow on that, I think. So just looking around here, I mean, the tech that was in this before has paid no care and attention. I mean, there's flux everywhere, there's bits of solder on the board. That's not good, having a bit of solder floating around. That could bridge something. I mean, look at all the mess across here. I mean, look at all this. Why is the thermal compound there? Why is there just like a film of dirty thermal compound across everything. Why is it there? It shouldn't be there. And the APU, it looks like it's just cleaned the die and then just slapped some stuff on there and put it together and picked it, packed it and f***ed it off, basically. But overall, not too bad, I suppose. These joints look very cold. So it looks like the port was dropped in. So the solder was molten, the port was cold. So as soon as the port touched that molten solder, sapped all the heat out of it, and he's put the port in, and it's turned into like plastic state, not quite molten, not quite solid, and it's got quite a texture on it. That's bad. That could crack and break. Although the pins at the back on this port look good, let's get that reflowed, test it. If we get a display, I'm replacing that port, because again, we had a conversation in Discord not so long ago on the Coder's World, and although it might, as Phil said, might sound a bit disrespectful, but it isn't. If another technician has looked at something and then it lands on your healing bench, never assume that that previous tech has done a good job. Always go back and recheck the work. And any doubts, just replace the work, because, I mean, for instance, this has now landed on my bench. If I get this working, but I don't do anything about that port, and I've noted that those joints don't look great, and this port, these crack, and this port falls off, that's my fault. It ain't going to go back to the other tech. Right, let's do this. I also want to clean this site, because I don't know what flux is used. It could be garbage flux, and you can see some flux there. I don't want any of that flowing over to this port and mixing with it, so I'm going to clean the area first. Try and get rid of, although it is quite a clean area, I just don't want any contaminants going into any of my materials. You might think it's overkill, but hey ho. It's on my bench, I'm doing it, so. Okay, clean. Happy and clean. Right, let's flood this with a lot of flux. Some heat. Okay, can we all see? You can all see. Okay, we're looking for a little bit of movement in this IC, and then we'll know that the balls underneath have become molten. And we're just waiting for the balls to drop. Yep. BGA reballing has that many double entendres in it. Okay, I'm going to really ramp up the heat now. Okay, I'm getting there. Oh, see it move then. Tiny little bit of movement. Okay, that chip looks level already. There we go, we've got bubbling happening. A little bit longer. Okay, I'm going to leave it there. Okay, I want to say that's a lot flatter now. We're just going to leave that to cool naturally. So whatever flux that was left under that IC, not left, the flux that I put on there and then half of it swam over here. So whatever was left under that chip has been absorbed by the solder. So that's good. As you can see, the cotton swab is relatively clean. Okay, it's clean enough for what we need. Nice shiny balls there, you can definitely see them now. Can you see them now? Look at that. And that one, so the one on the corner, on the right, far right corner, and then the one in to the left, see how shiny he is? So he's, that chip has leveled out. That is now in contact with the PCB and the IC. There is a missing ball there. That it isn't like one ball per grid on this IC. There are missing balls on here, so that's nothing to worry about. The chip looks level. Could be leveler. It's up on that left hand side slightly. They're nice and uniform now. Chip is level. Let's see if we get a diode reading on pin 18. Okay, so we got diode readings on all of the important pins on the HDMI port except for pin 18. That was open line. There we go, we got a nice normal reading then. In fact, I'll just go from this solder point here. Says confidently, oh my god, there we go. So that pad there goes to pin 18. We're alive, so let's test. Okay, we're ready for a test. Come on. Yes! Oh, it's in low resolution mode. Ooh. Check it out. Nice. Right, controller. Ooh, 1080. Fucking come on. Yes. Done. Excellent. I mean, 4K and HDR haven't been confirmed yet, but that is a good sign. So sort out that port, get a new one on there, get it soldered in correctly, nice, strong, ready to go. Get that APU cleaned up, clean up the rest of his mess, get it assembled, get it tested, get it out. Cool. So yeah, they've definitely done the drop technique on this, but they didn't apply enough heat because the joints went dry. They were definitely dry and there is, you know, sunken in soldering them joints. I mean, that one there you can definitely see from that side. I mean, it's like got texture of rock. Shouldn't be like that. That is a cold solder joint. And I don't think any of the front anchor points have been soldered to either. Because if this lifts slightly now, which it does, you can see it move. So none of the front anchor points are soldered. So, alright, let's go. Go. Oh, look at the state of that solder in them holes. Oh, that's a horror show. Oh, they're like rusty drain pipes.
That's nasty. Oh man. That's no good at all. That's what dry joints look like when there's not enough heat, not enough flux. See how shiny that one's come up now? One half of it. Oh, that's mixed in with lead free. So it's like Play-Doh. It's like dried out Play-Doh. Keep the heat on. Nice. Get out. Cool. Oops. Ah, cooking my hand. Okay. We're good. That sight looks awesome. Pads look perfect. Holes are clean. Yep, there is a tiny little bit there, but who cares about that? Super clean. Let's get some fresh solder on them pads. Out hot. Everything is screaming up. I can't rest my hand on anything. Cool. Oh, front anchor points. I didn't forget, honest. These might look small and insignificant, but I promise you they are super important to the strength of this port. Don't forget them. You can see the board's just sapping the heat out of the iron. It's actually getting stuck to the pads a little bit. Okay, cool. Again, because I've got everything so hot, the iron's over 400 degrees, the flux is just oxidizing because it's not exactly designed to be used at that higher temperature. So that's why I use so much of the stuff and clean it off. As soon as it goes brown, I like to clean it off, put fresh down, because otherwise you can end up contaminating the joints and creating high resistance. Cool, that is a nice sight. Epoxy, leave him, he's fine, you're doing no harm at all, you're just creating work for yourself if you feel like you're having to chisel that off. Okay, plenty of wiggle room there, pins line up perfect. So before we do that, just want to tin up these anchor points. To be honest, I want them to stand really proud, because when we hot air this port on, you can actually see the port lower once these front ones melt, and it's such a good indicator that you are in the right ballpark of temperature and things are flowing and working as they should. So that looked like an excessive amount. I'm not really that bothered. It is under the port, and there's nothing here that can be bridged. Okay, let's get the area nice and hot and get the port close to the heat so we're not thermal shocking it. So the port gets a bit of heat into it as well. Always keep everything close by. I do this with ICs, like HDMI ICs, so when I'm heating up the area, I make sure the IC is close by. Without burning my fingers to bits, which this is. Okay, we're getting there. Board's coming up to temp. Looks like everything looks shiny. We're there. Just waiting for this end one to go. There we go, we've gone. So everything is up to temp. There's a good amount of heat in the port as well. Just gotta get it on there because it's burning my fingers. Make sure that port is forward. Hopefully we should see it shift slightly as those front anchor points start adhering. Maybe it was molten to begin with. Make sure that port is properly forward. Put a bit of pressure on him. Oops, seat sink then. That was good. What we wanted to see. Okay, I'm going to leave him there. And I'm just going to put a second longer. There we go. So at this point, I'm going to let this cool a little bit. I'm going to give the port a waggle. And if those front anchor points haven't adhered, you will see the port actually hinge along these pins here, but if they are adhered, you'll see the entire board move. Sorry if I'm shouting the hot air really loud. Okay, so still bloody up, but it's cool enough. So does the board move or does the port move? The board moves. Don't know if that's coming across because I do have an anchor point really close by, but you can see the board move. Port is rock solid and those four anchor points aren't even soldered yet. So that just goes to show how much strength is in those anchor points at the front there. They are super important. Let's touch up my pins. Potentially it's not needed. Should we give them a wiggle test? Solid. Yeah, they're all absolutely rock solid. I mean, they are soldered all the way along the length of them. Yeah, they're all rock solid. I'm not going to touch them. Okay, it's normal for those pins to not come through to the other side. It's just the way these ports are designed. So we're going to have to pummel some heat into this along with the soldering iron. So I'm going to need my big boy tip. So this one, D52, and we'll just wank it up to way over 400. We will get some hot air at about 350 degrees. That should be enough to float these anchor points. Ideally without the port dropping back out again. So we'll start off with this and just literally flood it. I'm going to see a nice big blob on the top, like that. Maybe not like that, like that. And same on this side. And then when we apply hot air, we should see most of that sink into the hole. Looks excessive and scary. Could be a little bit neater, but I'm happy with that. If we look at these front anchor points, because there was like four along the front and then two on the sides, so you've got the two main through hole ones there and then you've got this one here. You can see how the solder has flown actually up the side there. And then we've got these ones at the front. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and you can definitely see that those are, they are now one with the board. And there's the one on the side. It hasn't crept up the port as much as the other side, but you can see that that is, I think it's one. We've got a nice bit of creep of solder through there as well. That port is rock solid. Okay, a bit of perspective. There's the anchor points. There's the IC that we worked on. It's the back of the port. Okay, excellent. Now we get the fun of cleaning all of that up. Great. I'm actually going to mount the board for this. Nice squish. TV's on. She works. Cool. And the wiggle test. if you can see it just there, yeah, wailing on that. Cool, that's a fix. And as we saw, we now have a perfectly working Xbox Series X. This system was originally from another repair shop, and what we discovered was that they changed the HDMI port. It had some dry joints on the anchor points, so that didn't look overly great. But the more alarming thing was that the ESD booster IC, which is a glass BGA IC, which is super delicate, had actually floated and came away from the board slightly. First alarm bell was doing diode readings on the HDMI pins, and we found that pin 18 was completely open line, where in diode reading you should get a 0.56 type of reading, and it was just completely dead. On further inspection under the microscope, we saw that the chip was in fact like a country mile away from the PCB, and the solder balls looked, well, they weren't solder balls, they were just completely elongated and no good at all. So we flushed it with flux, reheated it, the chip sat flat and all the balls became uniform. We got a diode reading of pin 18. We then tested it with the old port and we got a display in 1080p, so that was good enough to go ahead and replace the port with a known good one. We've flown the port correctly onto the board, it's strong, all the anchor points are soldered, and this is now off for test on the big TV. So as always, I really appreciate you watching. Any issues with consoles or their corresponding controllers, give us a shout, link is in the description below. Take care, thank you.